Yo, champs in the making, and welcome back to Legendary Adventures. My name is Eli, aka That Big Sauce Gamer Tag.
And I'm Becky, aka Small Fry.
And guys, today's going to be a little bit different, mainly because we are hitting a milestone, and we are happy to
and
go ahead
and... a personal goal for us.
Right. This is the 100th episode, guys.
Yay! 100th. Yo!
No joke, guys, where do we even start? A few months back ago, we kicked off the channel, and you know what? We dove into gameplay just right out of the gate.
That's
and with little to no info on us, and we appreciate you guys following us. We appreciate you guys watching this.
It's
time that we went ahead and shared a little bit more about ourselves in regards to who we are, why we do this, why we love this, and of course a bit more. All right, guys. So as you know, Eli, Becky, That Big Sauce,
Small Fry,
the gamer tags. So you guys know how to follow us in regards to the screen watching, but the reality is we're husband and wife, 2 years married, blessed in regards to that. Guys, what can we say about ourselves? We're Pokemon enthusiasts, connoisseurs of great pizza.
and great food. We're foodies.
We are huge foodies. On top of that, we're not only big gamers of the Pokemon franchise, but also just regular video gaming in itself.
Oh yeah, we settle a lot of our disputes via gaming.
yeah, it's great to go ahead and do that. It's also tough to go ahead and do that, especially when we're both competitive.
Yeah.
And sometimes you don't, you're supposed to settle things on one round of Mario Kart, and yeah, it doesn't work out that way. Tournaments happen all night long.
True.
Or Smash Brothers. But with that said, guys, on top of being that, we have much love for our community in itself.
Yeah.
Becky here, you are a Riverside County native, right?
Oh yeah, I grew up in Riverside, you guys. So for me, I really, really have a big love for you guys.
Now, myself, I grew up in Orange County. Out in Costa Mesa, love the city, love the county itself, but you know, let's face it, once I got my driver's license, guys, I drove all over Southern California and loved meeting new people, new places, and in part that's why we go ahead and play Pogo, the style that we do.
That's so true. We love new experiences, you guys, and it just exploring a city is just like, wow, I love it. We love it.
Mm-hmm.
How did you get into Pokemon?
I got into Pokemon because of the trading card game back in grade school. Became a huge fan of it, loved card games, and Pokemon just had the greatest little monsters, the little designs, the attacks, everything was amazing, and plus being able to trade it was always great. And then, of course, the Game Boy games came out, jumped on Red. Silver became my all-time favorite for the longest time, and then played the series through and through. Honestly, some of the best memories I've had playing a video game series has got to be Pokemon, and that's where my love is for it, as well as the anime and the manga series and everything else that dives into it. How about you?
I got into it because of my brother, and we would watch the cartoons together. And
comment down below real quick, if family got you into the Pokemon series world, you know, older brothers, older sisters, you know, let us know. But sorry, babe, go right ahead.
Yeah, well, that's basically how I got into it with my brother, and I just remember us going to the Mission Grove theaters and watching the Pokemon movie, the one that first came out in the theater, and we were just so pumped up, super excited, and
with the real Mewtwo.
And we went with my mom, and it was like a really, really great time.
Now, it's safe to say that you jumped into Pokemon Go because already the love of the game for Pokemon Go, right?
Right.
So that's why you play it?
Yeah.
Okay. When the game came out, I jumped onto it and was in love with it. Even if it was the dark days of grinding out Pidgeys and Rattatats and all the trespassing to just go ahead and catch that Rattata. But sadly, I didn't keep my original account. And playing the game in itself, my previous account had gotten hacked into. And, you know, for security reasons, had to destroy it. And everything ended on there. The reason we started playing Pokemon Go again is because someone close to us had fallen deep into depression, and into hard times, and we were having difficulty trying to get the person out of their home, out of their own mindset, to be their old selves. And thank goodness to this game that it was a way to go ahead and bring them out of their shell, bring them outside, get them to be excited about things again. We were able to go ahead and enjoy their company, mm-hmm. and watch them leave that depression behind, which is one of the reasons why we love playing this game so much, is because of this game we've met so many of you fellow trainers.
Seriously, it like brings us together. I have never experienced something like this, and I've never seen anything like this in any game or anything like that. That we seriously come together as a community and like work together, and I don't know, just
it's amazing, honestly. You know, we've met so many of you guys trainers, like, you know, she said that, you know, you guys are shy, you guys are introverts, you're fighting depression, you're fighting anxiety, and you know, you've given us the opportunity to go ahead and play with you guys, and that's the key item in itself. We, as much as we love grinding for Stardust and for the Pokemon and for the shinies, honestly, we just love playing with people. There's nothing better than going out and about and obtaining a new friend, a new acquaintance, someone that is excited about this stuff. You know, it's lunchtime all over again at recess, or in the sense of like you're running with your Game Boy Advance and your cable, and you want to trade Pokemon and you want to battle, and this is it. But you know, now. We don't have to wait for lunch or recess. Now we can just go ahead and find you out and about.
We'll have to wait for dinner hours, and I'm just kidding, community days.
And raids and community days, yes. But nonetheless, it gives us that opportunity to go ahead and connect and bond with everyone. So you guys know now why we started playing again. Mm-hmm. What drove us even further to go ahead and play, what was it, like almost a year hiatus from when my account got deleted is when we came back to this. Mm-hmm. But what made it amazing, and the reason we started recording this, is because we wanted to go ahead and share this experience. You know,
exactly.
It's not so much about our excitement to catch a shiny. I mean, we are happy, shiny, just shiny, like shiny, you yourselves shiny, are always shiny, happy shiny. When you get one. But genuinely, and with the exception of joking around about being salty, we are happy when everyone else, you know, manages to get a shiny. We understand, like we said, that people who normally wouldn't be socializing in this manner, we're out there helping each other to go ahead and get that shiny.
Like, just break out of your shell. You literally see people break out of their little comfort zones and like go out of their way to help somebody out, and that's super amazing. We really wanted to show the community, like you guys, and how you guys accepted us, and like, I don't know, you guys were so open to every single trainer out there that it's like, okay, we want to show that to like everyone.
Definitely. I mean, you know, dude, let's face it, if you're roughly my age, and I won't discuss my age just yet, but there was a time where you kind of had to deny this, your fandom for Pokemon, because you'd get picked on.
Super bullied. And
you'd get bullied about it. Mm-hmm. And you know what? Some of that kind of lingered over when the game came out and people were afraid to go ahead and talk and play. And you know what? There's no greater equalizer than to have a love for a game, a passion for this game, whether you are a trainer that likes to just complete the Pokedex, mm-hmm. get all the shinies, or you're in it for the raids, or for take over your neighborhood and own all the gyms and have the gold medal, or true. Now the shadow Pokemon, and you know, whatever the case may be, you know, it brings us all together. And honestly, there's nothing better than, you know, coming across people that normally don't get a chance to raid with other people, you know, to form up a little group and go have a great time. And you know, for 20 minutes, an hour to an afternoon, you know, you yourself are on your own console quest, and that's what's amazing about this. Okay, so in regards to, well, let's face it, like we said, we're Pokemon fans from way back when. We all have favorite Pokemon and the overall favorite Pokemon. So we all want to know, Becky, who's your favorite Pokemon?
In the game or in general?
Okay, let's go with in general, and then with what's available in Pokemon Go right now.
Okay, so in general, I would say Beware, because Like, when she first appeared in the anime, it was just, like, so cute because she doesn't know her own strength. And she's super, super, like... She will, like, wail her arms around and... No, wait.
Yeah? No, you're right. You're right. She's right.
She wails her arms around, and then it's just, like, you think that she's, like, saying hi to you, but in fact, it's, like, keep away from her because, like, she's pretty dangerous. She's not aware. And she's pretty nice because she opened up her home to Team Rocket, so...
Yeah. Wow, love for Team Rocket. Guys, my marriage may be on the rocks after that comment. No, I'm kidding. But with that said, so that's cool. And so who's your favorite Pokemon in Pokemon Go?
Rayquaza. It has to be Rayquaza.
Of course. Ray.
So dope. They're both very powerful. They're strong. I like strong Pokemon.
Okay.
Either Beware is strong fighting, normal fighting, and then Rayquaza is dragon. That's like very different, but they're both very strong. So.
Okay. All right. Now, I've already mentioned on the channel what my favorite Pokemon is. And this, of course, is in part with the Gen 1 series. For me, it will be Primeape. Fell in love with him because of the anime. And, of course, I have a particular fondness for fighting and also ghost-type Pokemon.
Oh, what's up for fighting?
With that said, my all-time favorite Pokemon happens to be Marshadow because it's a beast. It's a beast of a Pokemon.
He's awesome.
don't let the cuteness fool you. It'll wreck you. All right, guys. So with level zero being achieved, which is what we consider
level zero complete, done.
You know, when we started this channel out in itself, we put ourselves to simple goals. We never voiced them out, not because we didn't think anyone wanted to hear about them, but because, you know, when you're working and collaborating with your partner, your best friend, you kind of like shoot these goals at each other. We wanted to find out if we could go ahead and post every single day, which we achieved multiple times.
Yeah.
Which is not easy because we both have full-time jobs. You know, we do have our marriage to go ahead and give attention and time to, and then of course we have friends and family that, you know, that require our love and attention as well, to go ahead and partake in that, and of course whatever life throws your way. But with that being achieved, with 100 episodes being achieved, because honestly we started this pretty much at the end of February, and it's what, 6 months? That's insane. Like, I honestly thought it would take us a year to maybe a year and a half, but as you guys know, the Pokemon Go has so much content. And honestly, it's just any chance you can go ahead and get out and play and meet new people, it's what it is. And so in the next 100 episodes, we're gonna go ahead and try to visit more areas, more cities, and every county, because we want to go ahead and meet you guys. We also want to know where great places to play are. We also want to know where there's a great place to eat, honestly.
Yeah,
because let's face it, after running around, you know, doing 3 hours of community day, you're hungry.
We're hungry, super hungry. We're like, let's go get food every single time.
So I mean, that's pretty much where we're pushing there. And then hopefully, of course, being able to travel further out from this state, you know, go to your guys' states and or countries, and you know, get to not only geotag our Pokemon, but most importantly go ahead and create friendships and capture smiles.
Seriously, showcase your community. That's basically what we want.
Yeah. And it doesn't matter if your community is a small group of friends or a giant
true.
Discord group. We want to meet you guys. That's the point of all this, is that we want to go ahead and meet the community, showcase you guys, because you guys are what makes this game fun.
Yeah, we just really wanted to say thank you guys to everyone that supports this channel, that hits the thumbs up, that likes. We really, really appreciate you guys.
For real, you know, for sharing our little pieces of work that we create for you guys. You know, when you share it with your friends, when you repost it on Twitter or Facebook,
and
or even
your
Instagram.
Comments, you guys. Seriously,
your comments.
We're like so happy to interact with you guys.
Exactly. You know, we love it. And then, of course, guys, you know, go ahead and drop your gamer codes into the listing still, because we are still adding friends to our friends list.
Yeah.
So with both of us, we can always go ahead and add one person or both to our team, and then of course circulate those gifts. But guys, we just want to thank you again
thank you so much
for spending just, you know, a little bit of time of your day hanging out with us. And guys, you guys know the deal. Don't forget to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, smash that bell, and until next time, peace.